Okay, fire away, guys.
Just talk about the addition of Foster Royal, just kind of what you've seen with the program so far.
Well, look, we only had him here for, a couple of days. I like the addition, like the person, like the player. He's got some versatility. He can play both in line and in a move position. He's smart. He's tough. He's a lot of the characteristics that we look for in Saints players. So I think he'll be a good addition. I like the fact that, Derek has some familiarity with him.
Did you expect to get him? Was that part of making the deal to send Adam Trautman away?
Yeah, I don't know if expect to get him was necessarily the case. I think we knew that he was going to be cleared to participate, and we felt like that, we were a destination that he was certainly interested in. But it's never done until it's done, and so as soon as the draft was over, we had some communication. I will say that, we knew where we were looking, and it was just a matter of trying to get something done.
And who's kind of looking for in the rookie camp?
The primary thing right now is just get base fundamentals and just a basic knowledge of our scheme and what we're doing, and then a lot of the work that we're doing in this rookie minicamp is skill development, technique oriented. We really basically had about 8 plays of 7-on-7, about 8 plays a team. So it's not really a team deal as much as it is. We got a lot of meetings, get them kind of accustomed to what it's like being in an NFL organization, and really get a lot of work on fundamentals and technique.
Do you like the size, strength, weight, everything that Brian Brzee's at right now? After I know we've battled a lot of that stuff.
Yeah, look, he looks great, we're excited about what we think he can bring. There's an athletic quality to his game that we like inside at the defensive tackle position. So, he's 6'5", 310, somewhere in that area, and I like that.
Yeah, I noticed you guys had 3 different groups of defensive backs working out there. Just how beneficial is it to have that much depth in your coaching staff that you have that many coaches that can help out and do different things?
Yeah, look, I think it's good. I mean, everybody's kind of got their role that they're playing. I feel like we've made some good additions to the staff this year, and certainly time will tell, but feel good about where we're at. There's some continuity and some things that we're going to have to kind of get adjusted to a little bit. There's a lot of guys still learning on the fly in terms of exactly what we're doing and how we're doing it, but I like where we're at.
Are you evaluating the new coaches as much now, or is it focusing on the rookies?
I think everything's being evaluated, we're all – look, everything that we do is based on – how are we going to be the best version of ourselves that we can be when we get to the season? And so in doing that, everything that we do from a coaching standpoint, from a playing standpoint, everything's being evaluated. And, we got to see what we do, really well. And those will be the things that we'll focus on as we get into the season.
How close would you say Kendre Miller is? And what are maybe some of the things you like about him?
Well, look, I'll talk about what I like about the player. I don't really want to get into how close he is. That's kind of a relative term. But, certainly we expect to have him. I don't expect him to miss anything when we get to training camp or anything like that. But I like the player in that I like his downhill running style. I think he's got really good feet. I think he's got really good contact balance. And he's got the speed to take it the distance if he breaks free in the open field. So there's a lot of qualities about him that I like. And look, I don't know that they used him as much out of the backfield at TCU, but yet I think he's got that skill set.
Still a couple of open spots in the 90-man roster. You're still kind of evaluating some of the options that are available out there for you.
Yeah, I think when we went through the finishing process of the draft, one of the things that we really wanted to do was try to identify free agent players that we really liked. And we weren't just trying to fill magnets. We were trying to find guys that had a redeeming quality that we thought we could work to develop. And so in doing that, We didn't fill up to the to a 90-man roster. There's still a lot of things that we can do between now and training camp to get there. But the key to me is really just trying to identify guys that we like or have a skill set that we like that we think we can develop and work with and gives those guys a chance.
Just so I don't put words in mouth, Bill Magnus, I mean.
Yeah, so, you know, you put your depth chart up on the board and, you know, you got a magnet with the name and where the kid went to school, height, weight, speed, all that kind of good stuff. And so there's 90 magnets that go up on the board and probably when we finished the draft or prior to the draft, I think we were at 68 players on our roster. I want to say we got to about 86. There's been a few, you know, subtractions since then. So I want to say we're somewhere right around that number, 85, 86, something like that right now. I don't know exactly what that number is, but we're going to continue to evaluate anything we can do to try to upgrade the roster. We're going to try to do that.
Are you planning to go into next week with three kickers, and is that
unique? Well, we're afforded that opportunity because we have the extra roster spots. I don't anticipate that we'll go all the way into training camp with three kickers, but the two that we have in here right now, you know, we like as potential competition, and we're going to keep evaluating those guys and see where we're at. No, we're not looking for left. No, I mean, obviously, it's different, you know, from a left-handed standpoint. But no, that's really didn't go into our thought process. It's a good idea, though. Well, look, we just got him out here today, but what we do like about him is I think he's a pretty good athlete, a little bit more of a move type of F player, and he's been a pretty good special teams player in our league, and so I think that was something that we wanted to look at to make sure that we had some guys. You know, obviously we have Taysom at the tight end position that has a valuable role on special teams. But we wanted to continue to look to see if there was somebody else that we could add that had some value as an offensive player, but yet also had potentially some value as a special teams player. Yeah, extremely intelligent. I think that would be the first thing that I would say. You can watch him out there. Fundamentally, he does a good job. He does a really good job of getting through his progressions. Throws the ball with timing and accuracy. So a lot of qualities that you like at the quarterback position, particularly from the neck up.
When you got the schedule the other day, was there anything that jumped out at you, good, bad, anything?
Well, look, I mean, I think the number one thing you're looking at is who do you open up against? You know, we open up against Tennessee, who's you know, I have a lot of respect for Mike Vrabel and what he's done with his with that organization, with that football team. I know it's going to be a tough physical matchup to open up the season. You know, you're looking at, you know, what are the potential weather games that you might have, which we don't really have. I think the number's like 14 or 13 games inside. And so there's not a lot of weather issues that we're going to have to face this year. Certainly, you know, the two short week Thursday night games is a challenge. You know, we're one of the few teams that is dealing with that this year, so it'll be something new for us to experience.
Dennis, you brought in quarterback Harrison Frost from a Division II program. When you bring a player in from a small school here to an NFL camp, what are you looking for out of them?
Yeah, I think just, you know, particularly at that position, you know, you're looking at you know, how quickly can they pick up what we're doing in this particular case from an offensive schematic standpoint? So what's their intelligence level? And you know, how do they fit in when you're bringing in whatever we got 50 guys in here that you know, are NFL caliber players? And so I think he's done a nice job in this camp. It's probably too much of a medical deal for me to kind of get into, but yeah, we don't anticipate that there's going to be any issues with him in terms of being able to participate. And all the information that I have is that it's very positive in terms of his recovery.
Is that like tricky at all to project like when he would play again? Because I understand it'd be more conditioning, right? Like post-treatment and how he feels.
Well, I think again, you know, we took in all the information we could from a medical standpoint. Like, that's not our, like, it's not our area of expertise, so we're leaning on the doctors there in terms of making a good decision there. You know, Dr. Amos felt really, really positive about not only the treatment plan for him, but also his recovery and his ability then to participate. So I really don't anticipate that to be, you know, a challenge that we're going to, you know, have to deal with. You know, obviously it's a serious medical condition, so you don't ever want to take that lightly.
So he could conceivably participate in OTAs coming up?
Absolutely.
Tito, Kendra, is like his route running, is that something you guys kind of got to work on because he didn't do much, or is that there and it's just kind of waiting?
I think the skill set is there. He hadn't done a lot of it, so I'm sure there's going to be some work in progress there. But you know, the start of that is just having the ability to, and certainly we feel like he has the ability to do that. We've seen him catch the ball. We feel like he's got good hands, you know, so I think that's a part of his game that we'll work to develop, but I think there's a skill set there that will be able to do it.
How does adding a guy like Foster Moreau potentially impact y'all's ability on the offensive side to use Taysom in additional places?
Yeah, well, I don't know that it necessarily is like, okay, we added Foster, and so now that changes Taysom's role in any way. I still have this vision of using Taysom in the same way that we've been able to use him in the past. Look, certainly I think we've added some weapons, you know, to the offensive side of the ball, which I think is going to be good. And you know, and then Derek will do a good job of distributing the ball to all the playmakers. Yeah, so he's still recovering. There was some hardware in his foot that they took out. I guess it's probably been, you know, week and a half ago. We feel good about where he's at in terms of his recovery. And, you know, when we get him out here, we expect that we're going to get him out here and get the player that we've had in the past. I don't know if I think it's all good news. You know what I mean? Like it's just everything's been positive in terms of, look, you get this negative information that obviously impacts a young man's life. And yet, the prognosis for recovery, and the prognosis in terms of the treatment plan has all been, you know, extremely positive. And so in that way, we feel good about it.
Yeah, so you feel like you still have some significant work to do on this roster, you know, in free agency or whatever between now and training camp, or do you feel pretty good about where you are right now?
Yeah, I think there's still some spots that we can add some players to help our football team. And we're gonna constantly be evaluating that to see what we can do to make us better. But yet, at the same time, I feel pretty good about where we're at. I don't see any real huge significant holes in our roster. You know, probably there's some depth things that I'd like to make sure that we shore up. And we'll keep looking at that. We got a lot of time before we start training camp, so you know, it's always a constant evaluation.
What are some of the things that stand out to you about Marcus Robertson, especially after getting to see him a little bit more?
Well, I've worked with him before. You know, I like the fact that he's played the game. And I like the fact that, you know, he was a huge part of at the Raiders when we took Charles Woodson and he really converted from kind kind of an outside corner. Then he was more of a nickel, and then went to safety. And Marcus worked a lot with him in terms of, you know, helping him, because the game is played differently. Obviously, Charles is a Hall of Fame player, but you know, there's still an adjustment there. I thought he was a big part of that transition for Charles, and so I think he'll do a really good job in the back end.